Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, everyone. Thank you for having me. And it's an honor to share with you all in one of prestigious ERA webinars. Since the topic of our webinar today is how to use literature to help readers cope with challenges, I would like to share with you my journey with my students, whom I usually call my friends, under the title, Our Literature Journey in Exploring the World of Education, Reading Literary Works for Educational Purpose. So to me, one of the big challenges that I face is dealing with those who think that reading literary works is not relevant in education study program. I recall my experience during accreditation of ELSP back then in 2018. One of the assessors argued to have educational subjects only without dealing with literature. I also joined some seminars questioning the study of literature in education study program. There are some people who think that it is not important to read literary works when studying in an education study program. In conclusion, we have a big question. Do we need to read literary works when we study in other field, in this case, education? Secondly, in this pandemic, students can face some problems, for example, boredom for having online classes, a killer teacher or lecture, lack of motivation, etc. The question is, can literary works help our students cope with those problems? For answering those questions, I would like to invite you all to see our documentation of exploring the world of education by reading literary works, how some literary works can also help students cope some challenges that they face. To be specific, I choose prose in English language teaching course as an example. There are three literary works read in this story, in this course, sorry. The first is Miss Awful by Arthur Kavanagh, and the second is The Little Girl at the Window by Tatsuko Kuroyanagi, and the third is The Jungle School by Putat Manurung. So we will go to England, Japan, and Indonesia through those three literary works. Okay, so let's begin. Miss Awful is an interesting story where you can find two teachers who treat their students differently and a student named Roger. Miss Wilson is characterized as a nice teacher. Roger told the character of Miss Wilson, "Well, I like Miss Wilson. She's fun." Last week, for instance, when Tommy Miller got tired of staying in his seat and lay down on the floor, pretty soon the whole class was lying down. Know what Wilson did? She lay down on the floor too. Roger went on. She said we'd all have a rest. It was perfectly normal in the middle of the day. That's what I love about St. Job's. It's fun. Roger said. On the other hand, Miss Orville is an old and strict teacher. "Attention, please. No muttering in the back." She cleared her voice and resumed. "Prior to my retirement, I taught boys and girls for 46 years, she warned. "I am beyond trickery, so I advise you to try none. You are to be in my charge until the return of Miss Wilson, however long that may be." She claps her hand in front of her and trains her full scrutiny on the rose. So almost all students dislike her. So do students' parents. They do not like Miss Orville. Miss Orville is so disciplined and she wants her students to learn more and do their best. And we have Roger. who was unable to spell any word and liked to play around. He has some experiences with both Miss Wilson and Miss Orville or Miss Oval. So Roger, in the beginning of the story, is characterized as a playful boy who likes to bring toys at school, ignore homeworks, and in short, he is not serious. But in the end of the story, he could spell words well because he experiences Miss Orville's teaching process, so he learns. Roger stood back, hands at his side, and lifted his hat erectly. Flower, he spelled F-L-O-W-E-R. He squared his shoulders and looked at Miss Orville's brimming eyes. Castle, Roger spelled C-A-S-T-L-E. So, although Miss Orville is seen to be the awful one by both students and parents, C has good intention for her students. To attend school is a privilege you must not mock. Can you guess how many thousands of children in the world are denied the gift of schooling? Her lips quivered. It is a priceless gift. You cannot permit yourself to squander a moment of it. She rose from her desk and looked down at the rows of boys and girls. It isn't enough any longer to accept a gift and make no return for it, not with the world in the shape it's in, she said. Spectacles rambling on her bony nose. The world isn't a playbook, she said. If I have been civil with you this past week, it was for your benefit. The world needs good citizens. If I have helped one of you to grow a fraction of an inch, if just one of you. So how amazing a short story can propose different perspective to its readers. After reading this short story, my students answered some guided questions. They related Miss Orville's short story to good teacher concepts and some educational values. For good teacher concepts, they have four streams. Here, we can also begin learning teacher identity. So four groups, some students like, what is it? The concept of Miss Wilson. So I like teacher who can make learning feel exciting and never put pressure on students. Teacher who can understand students struggling in learning. And then the second group here, combination between Miss Wilson and Miss Orville. So I like the type of teacher who is not too strict, but still follows the rules. Everything should be scheduled so that students will know what they will learn without waiting for the teacher to explain what they should do in each meeting. This also will help students to be prepared before the class started. I like a humorous and kind-hearted teacher. They rude. Okay, and then they also shared with me their own concept of a good teacher. So I love having a cheerful teacher, a teacher who brings happiness and gives good vibe for the students. He or she has enough time or gives opportunity for the students to ask, to consult and to hear students' difficulties. And the last is about good teacher concept during pandemic. So I'm sure we really want to know. My students share this one. A great teacher is the one who explains the material, knows students well. It means that the teacher will not give a lot of assignments only, okay? So that's for good teacher concepts. So for educational values, I picked some of their answers, which include good intention of a teacher, being disciplined, obligation to study, and family education. So here, every teacher has a good intention have to keep in mind that all love teachers, whether they seem annoying or really kind, they have good intention for their students. So the second one, it is about being disciplined. A good teacher must keep teaching students to be a good citizen and real human. Letting them doing what they want is actually not good at all. I will make them feel free and the intention to learn. It will make them feel free and the intention to learn is ceased. So this is one of what I said, the answers. And students' obligation is to study, just like what Mrs. Orfield stated to the whole class. Students cannot squander a moment of priceless gift to study in school. There are thousands of children who deny the gift of schooling. And the last is education starts from home. Discipline starts from home because how they act in school represent who they are at home. So these are only some examples of their answers. Okay. So now let's go to Japan. So we have the little girl at the window or Toto-chan. Every student has their own preference, yes. And the work of literature opens thousands of interpretations. So I begin the journey by giving a freedom for my students to choose the part that they like from a novel entitled The Little Girl at the Window or Toto-chan. I quoted from this novel, the children considered their trees, their own private property. So if you wanted to climb someone else's tree, you had to ask their permission very politely, saying, excuse me, may I come in? Kuroyanagi, page 29. Then I shared with them my reason of choosing that part, how nice it was to have that certain etiquette as a result of education. We had a Zoom meeting and I recorded our meeting. So please enjoy watching our recorded video.
Really nice. When you have someone you can talk to, for example, the headmaster listened to Toto-chan for like 4 hours straight, right? Plus, I feel like Toto-chan has mental health problems, because she is an unusual kid who likes doing things over and over again. And then she loves talking to other people like so much. So I think having someone who can talk to is making us feeling like our voices are being heard. And
it tells that the previous teacher of Toto-chan told her mother about the problem why Toto-chan has to be expelled from school. And I think this is quite funny for me because mostly children, if they are asked to stop doing something else at the class, they will stop directly at that time. But here, when Toto-chan was asked to stop, and then the teacher said that you can only open or shut the desk if you have if you need to put something or take something from the drawer, it's like that. And then at the end, the teacher said that she couldn't stop her because she already found the reason. So the reason, Toto-chan finds the reason why she could open the drawer.
But there was no time to explain. She simply said, why don't you ask him yourself? And anyway, what about Daddy? He plays the violin and owns several violins, but that doesn't make our house a violin shop, does it? Toto-chan agreed. Can you this scene? Because part explains her slowly and so doesn't get that's it.
Every student has their own favorite part. Yes. Okay. So starting from the part that they like, they try their best to build the connection with education and their own experience. They were not alone. So during the process of writing their reflective paper, I gave individual feedback after their first draft submission. I could gather various yet deep results of reflection and their critical thinking about our education. One of them is from Fida. So this is Fida's experience reflection, and I quoted some beautiful sentences. Teachers who know how to give the proper appreciation for students will increase students' motivation in learning. Therefore, students will wait for their class without missing a day. Wow, so deep. So giving freedom to choose the part that our students like creates relaxed atmosphere, since students can explore more and build the connection with our today's problem of education and their own experience together with their reflection. So now let's explore our beloved Indonesian literature. So after learning by reading and analyzing a story and a novel that were chosen by a team of lecturers, I shared with my students an Indonesian literary work that has been translated into English. The Indonesian version is Sekolah Rimba and the English is The Jungle School. This biography contains a story of a teacher named Butet Manurung and her students who are jungle children. I expect that this sharing can inspire my students to read more literary works that they can choose and begin their own journey for exploring the world of literature and connected with other fields. Since I'm in English language education study program, I try to learn an educational theory about self-regulated learning here. So self-regulated learning, there are consists of three parts: metacognitive, motivation, and behavior. So here, students should be able to plan and set their own goals, organize and have self-monitoring session, and they will be able to evaluate themselves. And then the second one, student who have self-regulated learning, or a student who is self-regulated learner, reports high self-efficacy, self-attribution, report intrinsic task interest. And then the behavior here, I think it's important also in this pandemic. So students should be able to select environments, set the environment, structure the environment, and this will be very beneficial because it optimizes learning process. So when the room is so noisy, so I think students should be able to choose other room that is not so noisy. Okay, so what about here in the jungle school? So jungle children know their goals and try to achieve those goals. How happy I was, well, until now I'm happy too, knowing that this can be an answer for facing our problems during pandemic. The first is metacognitive. Some quotations plan to show jungle children as students who know their goals, set the goals, and even try to achieve more than that. If I may conclude, the actions of asking a lot of questions are moving. So for example, setting the goal, how much longer before I can read? And then they also ask, they want to know, they need to coordinate time with the outside world. They know the goal, they set the goal, and they try to achieve that by constantly asking questions. They ask a lot of questions here, trying these words and that. Yes. So what about behavior here? The second part is about behavior, how to select environment, choose and set it. So here, jungle children are brave enough to ask Butet Manurung to come to the jungle. If you come to the jungle, we will learn. If you do not want to come to the jungle, we will not learn. And then here, they prefer riding here instead of their camp. So they choose the place where they can study. They could come and go. Yes, and they, what is it? They do not want to be in the same study group. So they will choose their own group for studying, for learning process. And then Gintar wants to study behind the house in the hut. Yes, and Mithi sits on the bicycle. So they have their own preference for, what is it, for the place of, yeah, to study. Okay, so here, strong motivation. This biography is able to inspire today's learners to reflect on themselves, whether we have strong motivation, know our goals and achieve those goals or not. Yes, for example, here on page 127, they rarely respond yes when I ask them if they are tired of learning. So they are not tired of learning, and they even request more work and compete. And then learn from those who have already acquired the skills, and they focus on comprehension rather than grades. So these Indonesian literature or literary work can inspire our students to, what is it, to have self-regulated learning more, to set their own goal, to achieve the goal, to set the environment, to select the environment, and to have strong motivation. Because a great learning process cannot only have a great teacher, it also requires a great learner too. So we will underline it, not only great teacher, but a great learner too. Okay, so back again to our previous questions. Do we need to read literary works when we study other fields, in this case, education? Can literary works help our students cope with those problems? Well, I think we get the answer. Thank you.